to be enlightened. Yes. I was a kid. And I usually don't do games and stuff. You know, like, why most of the time I come home from school. I know that they actually do have all the students who actually do the streams during the game and stuff.
Hello. Hello, Dolly. Well, good evening, everybody, and welcome to Donovan Catholic, where we are so happy to be presenting our spring musical. If we could all find our way to our seats, that would be wonderful. The lights are going to go out in a few seconds. So, we have a big house tonight. I've got lots of folks that have shown up, and we're really happy about that. How many of you have never, ever seen Hello, Dolly before? Really? That's great. You're in for a treat. Hello, Dolly has been around. I don't even know how old the show is. Anybody know? 64. So it's been around for a little while. And the thing I like about it is, I know that Carol Channing played the lead role, and Barbra Streisand played the role, and who else? Ethel Merman, did Ethel Merman play? And Pearl Bailey, and Louis Armstrong was in this, and you know, all these famous names. And people will discuss which ones they like the best. But I have to say I'm a little partial to the Dolly and cast that we have here tonight. These young men and women have been working really, really hard for a long, long time. I don't know how they do it, but they do it all with a smile. They do it all with a good sense of humor, not taking themselves too seriously, but taking their work very serious as they strive to put on the best show that they can for you. Thank you for your support of Donovan Catholic, and keep on coming. Hello, Dolly.
women in Yonkers, New York, arranging the second marriage of Mr. Horace Vanderdoppler, the well-known half-a-millionaire. As my late husband Echo Levi always said, that means she's got at least 60,000 cash. But don't worry, I'll work my hardest to have you carry across somebody's threshold before the week is out. Now, I should also mention I'm available for financial consultation, instruction in the guitar and mandolin, short distance calling, and, their postpaid for use. Ah, Mr. Pepper, the artist. You know, I'm something of an artist myself. I do those silhouettes with the black paper and scissors. Here's one of Ada Ray, hand looking the other way. I have to go with that because I'm no good at
nosing. Mrs. Levi, the train for yours will leave in 5 minutes, and if you don't get there on time...
But we will, Mr. Pepper, and not only will Mr. Vanderdoppler give you permission to marry the Peace Ermengarde, but he will also dance at your wedding, and not alone either, because I happen to be engaged in finding him a suitable second wife himself. What he really wants is someone steady to clean the house. My husband, Ethel Levi, always said marriage is a bride to make a housekeeper think she's a householder.
I know all about it, Mrs. Levi. Half of New York says he's going to propose to Irene Loy this very afternoon.
Which is exactly why I'm on my video offers right now. You can take on your case and knock off 4 lovebirds with 1 stone or whatever, bro. I'll see. Well, 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 what do we have here? It looks like I have nothing to pay my train fare with. Only large bills,
I think I just need to change your zone, Mrs. Levi. I hope this isn't a wild goose chase or nothing.
Oh, and speaking of poultry, I'm also available for fresh Jersey eggs, surgical corsets, three bones, ears pierced, and
This is Levi.
Furniture, my hand in here. I touch the little stir, a little him, a little her, a little shake, a little move, a little some protected soul, a little. When I use my fist, a little someone grab his kiss, a little pressure with the thumbs, matrimony comes when I put my hand in there.
This is me, Bob.
And in my now, Mr. Van Gogh. impertinent fool, that's what. And I'm promoting you from impertinent fool to chief clerk. Any more questions?
Yes.
What?
Does chief clerk get one evening off a week?
So that's the way you thank me for your promotion, is it? No, sir. You'll attend to the store as usual. Now get back to work. And don't forget to put the lid back up. Put the lid back on that chief clerk. Evening's up. Marrying artists. Foolishness. You know, 99% of the people in this world are fools. And the rest of us are in great danger of contamination. Why, even I was young once. Which was foolish. And got married. Which was foolish. And then I was poor. Which was more foolish than anything else. When my wife died. Which was foolish of her. And then I grew older, which was sensible of me, and became rich, friendless, and mean. Which in yonkers is about as far as you can go. Well, I know what you're wondering now. Why a man with so much good sense would be thinking of doing anything as foolish as getting married again? Well, the answer is simple. This house without a woman will be an empty shell. And pretty dirty, too. It takes a woman all powdered in pink to joyously clean out the drain and the sink. And it takes an angel long with the lashes and soft as a finger for cupping the ashes. Yes, it takes a woman, a dainty woman, a sweetheart, a mistress, so white. Oh, yes, it takes a woman, a fragile woman, to bring you the sweet things in life. That frail young maiden is constantly there for washing and brewing and shoeing the mare. And it takes a female for setting the table and weaning the Guernsey and cleaning the stable. Yes, it takes a woman, a dainty woman, a sweetheart, a mistress, a wife.
Thank you.
particularly at dinner.
Now look here, Mrs. Levi, you introduced me to Mrs. Malloy, and rumors are not, I intend calling on her again this afternoon, as arranged.
Very well, Mr. Vandenhofer, I'll meet you outside, perhaps I'll get to Kirby's as usual.
One more thing, Mrs. Levi. Those that don't.
Well then, Mr. Vandenhofer, I happen to have one more name on my list, a name I know as well as my own, but we won't get into that now. It'll come up all in itself in good time. Of course, I have this other girl for you, Ernestina. Wait till you see her. A vision. A dream.
It takes a woman of power in me to joyously clean out the drain sink, and it takes an angel with one of his lashes and soft as her fingers for dumping the ashes.
Yes, it takes a woman.
That's enough.
You'll go to the restaurant, and incidentally,
handle the ones on the top. Not too close. Look at them ready to bust. Holy hamburses! I smell from up here. Come on, Barney, we're going to New York. Out there, there's a world outside of Yonkers. Way out there beyond this big town you want to be. There's a sleek town, Barney. Out there, so shy and full of sparkle. Close your eyes and see it glisten, Barney. Listen, Barney. World out there, get out before you see them dying signals. We're gonna find adventure in the evening air. Girls in white, naked tonight, the lights are bright as the stars. When your Sunday close, we're gonna ride through town. One of those new horse-drawn open cars. We'll see the shows in Delmonico's. We'll close it down in the world. And we'll come home until we kiss a girl.
Yeah.
made for feathers, and all these cherries are going to be late as almost 10 o'clock. Oh, dear. Oh, dear. Oh, my. Would you look at that? Coming back from the shop, not open yet. It's all because of this impending marriage, I tell you. What marriage? Oh, I got you news. Why, the impending marriage Mrs. Levi is arranging between Mr. Horace Vanderbilder, the well-known nonstop millionaire, and my employer and friend, Miss Irene Malloy. Although, for that means, her letter to the face of her late husband, Mr. Peter Malloy, may he rest in peace for over the years, I'm not sure. He got a caution, you know. Oh, it's all she wants from her late husbands and new marriages, and on top of everything else, Miss Monroe returning her hat for the third time. Same old story, she wants to wear chairs and feathers, chairs and feathers. Catch a ball, I suppose. But if you ask me, she'd be better with a nice, heavy veil. I told her, ruins on our back is what will be bringing this summer if you want to have your gentleman's eye. But she had none of it. Chairs and feathers. And on same old days when that poor dear sweet Mrs. Malloy has enough on her mind, but with the door, it's stuck. It's not then pull! girl to ask, but I'm going to ask it anyhow. Do you know who is Stanley Dolly? No, me, I don't. You know all about us, my share of blossom. I'm not saying I'm sure she. Once you can offer a woman as long as you love her, but you can't.
Adventure is yet one week. All day long we wander around New York and nothing happens when you come to a quiet street in the city. Commander Gelder? Oh, is he still out there? He's sitting on that bench.
Please?
Are you sure it's an adventure? Don't have to ask, Barnaby. If you're anyone, you'll know it, alright? How much money do we have left? Not much. 40 cents for dinner, 30 cents for drinking that, and 20 cents to the whale. 9 cents, why? And those women come down with laughter. Customers, that's it. Maybe the best thing to do is make them think we're rich. Then you won't have to pay for a thing when two men about town looking for half the ladies food after me. Yes.
Lord.
Here for you, Zacko. Here, Barney Tucker.
My pleasure, gentlemen. Now, what can I do for you two?
You see, we're two ladies about town looking for hats to boy. We want a hat. The lady, of course. Never mind, said the lady, Mrs. Malloy. She's so pretty. Her hats are so pretty. That's so reasonable, too. Reasonable is under a dollar, but still makes you up to see that whale. You have to excuse my friends come all this way from the office to see a stuffed whale, and he's all excited. Keep an eye on the street, Barney. Maybe you'll see it pass by. Is it big and black with mean little red eyes? Yes. It's right on that bench.
Excuse me, but did you say Yonkers, Mr. Hackle?
Oh, yes, ma'am, Yonkers. And pardon me for saying this, but you should see Yonkers. Perhaps if Mr. Malloy would like to see Yonkers with me.
Well, I'm a
widow, Mr. Happel. You are? Barney, he's a widow! Oh, that's too bad. I'm sure Mr. Malloy would love to see Yonkers, especially in this hat. You, of course, not him. Hey, the rest of these, you're captain, aren't you? Well, don't let that scare you. I'd be willing to change your bitch. Mrs. Malloy. Would you ever have a Sunday free in the near future? Well, I'd be more than willing to show you Yonkers from top to bottom.
Well, I may be there sooner than you think.
Oh, really?
You see, I have a friend who lives in Yonkers.
Do you?
Well, perhaps you know him, although she's so foolish to ask me cases like that. It's Mr. Vanderbilt.
Horace Vanderbilt? A family from the same feed?
Do you know him?
No.
No.
Mr. Vanderbilt is a substantial man. in real life, they tell me.
A lovely man, Mrs. Malloy. Just lovely. Has one fault, as far as I know. Well, he's artist nails. Cornelius?
No, perhaps your friend might like this one.
Look out! Help us, Mrs. Malloy, Willis, man.
Goodness, what are you doing? Mr. Hackle?
Mrs. Malloy, I don't suppose Mrs. Levi is in here, is she? She was supposed to meet me on that bench half an hour ago. You know, when I make appointments, I expect people to be on time. Oh, here. I got your present. Chocolate covered peanuts, unshelled at the expensive kind. Did I have to see you in here speaking with two men?
Men, Mr. Roundabout, what would men be doing? Now, why don't we go back into my workroom? I'm so anxious for you to see it.
I saw it last week.
Well, what's going on the hay fee business? I hear you have three friends, all hot as nails, I mean.
What on earth are you talking about?
Yonkers, I hear it's a very beautiful city.
And who has been telling you about Yonkers, may I ask?
Nobody. A friend.
What friend?
You see, he...
He?
A customer, Mr. Vanderbilt, and someone quite well to do, as a matter of fact. And he was in your mind half the ladies, then.
I thought you might even know him, although it
would
be so foolish to ask in cases like that. So,
Mr. Cornelius
Hackle. I'm sorry, did you say Hackle?
Yes.
He happens to be my head clerk, that's all. Mrs. Malloy, I demand an explanation.
And I'm going to give it to you. Why shouldn't she know Cornelius Hackle? Everyone in New York knows Cornelius Hackle. He's in all the fashionable homes, at the opera. He's at the Harmony Gardens restaurant at least three times a week.
Impossible. He's only got $146.35, and I consider my own estate.
Oh, Mr. Vandergelder, you're killing me. He's one of the Hackles. They built the, canal.
What canal?
The Anahof. Both.
They ain't the same man.
Who took the horses off the carriage and pulled Jenny Lynn through the streets?
Who?
Cornelius Hackle. Oh. And who dressed up as a waiter at the Fifth Avenue Hotel and dropped an oyster down Mrs. Astor's? So I can't say it. But it was Cornelius Hackle. He's the, Playboy of New York. Now, Irene, don't deny it. I can see you're taking with him just like everybody else. Dolly, what are you saying? I've only seen him once in my life. Really, Dolly Eyes. Excuse me. Of course.
Take off your hats, sir. Ready to sing, you'll have to do your thing. And that's
Thank you. think I use is athletic.
Well, my heart is about to burst. My head is about to pop. And now that I'm dancing, who cares if I ever stop?
Your next dish is hopper. Glide and step and step and glide.
And everyone, stand aside! Wow, he's dancing.
and I live in. I'm fine. My daughter Freddy got married, you know.
Oh, did she?
I do remember last September. It's been a long time since you lived here, Miss Levi. A long, long time.
Ethel, let me go. It's been long enough, Ethel. Every evening for all these years, I let out the cat. I locked the door. I made myself a little rum toddy, and before I went to bed, I said a prayer, thanking God that I was independent. And then no one's life was mixed up with mine. Then, one night, Oakley fell out of my Bible. I kissed it there when you asked me to marry you, Ephraim. A perfectly good Oakley, but without color and without life. And suddenly I realized that I was like that leaf. For years, I had not shed one tear, nor had I been filled with the wonderful hope that something would turn out well. And so I've decided to rejoin the human race. And Ephraim, I want you to give me away.
Taste Saturday's highlight. Enjoy the parade.
Levi. You are hereby discharged as my marriage broker. Is that clear? From now on, you are just a woman like anyone else.
48.
Thank you.
except three elegant people never take hats.
Hats is out.
They're all no wise. Three cars. Jamie Vanderbilt, I'm Jim Morgan.
Then my Milwaukee is a streetcar. Imagine, I've been elegant all my life and I never even knew it.
Of course, if you really like to be elegant.
We do!
You walk. Yes, New York, it's really a sport of the end. Cornelius.
All I guess of Mr. Hackenlock, feeling great and looks spectacular. What a knack there is tonight, acting like a ball of mystery. I play not elegance in too late, not elegance you can never ever carry in your.
Thank you.
Ten is my order as head waiter for your Marine Guardians and your Supreme Commander. That's the night of our lights, our usual lightning service will be twice as lightning as ever, or else.
Thank you.
Champagne!
Oh,
once in a lifetime party, champagne, you know, pops and ice cream and hot house pizza. Give us a damn leader of how much to love us. We want music while we die.
Say, this is a cafe, isn't it? Let's dance!
The Bendigo does not dance this night. We're Presbyterian.
All right, I'll dance myself.
Here, you have $2 to Dolly over here, and someplace song number five.
I'm gonna do the Rocky Kitchy!
Or anything else.
Give this to the band there. Come play a waltz.
Thank you.
Avenger a half an hour late, and I demand an explanation of...
Thank you. Ernestina.
Exactly.
Ernestina, whom I trusted.
You wanted to do this.
She always was artistic. Now, Boris, I want our table moved down front. There's a dancer in the polka competition. I particularly want you to see. Recount my God, he's sure to win the solid gold cup.
Malloy. It's been a lovely evening, but I think it's time to head a bit.
I didn't fall in love with Miss Irene Malloy of the city in just an evening.
It was much quicker than that. An hour. No, you've been out too long. What's less than a penny?
A second.
Less than that. That's it. I'll go slowly so you can get us all down. He won't be some moment for your eyes to meet, and then your heart knows in a moment you will never be
Morris?
Without niece, without thirst, without bride, and without your purse. It looks like there's only one thing left to say.
If it's asking you to marry me, Dolly and mine, never, not in a million years would I ever marry you.
That wasn't it at all, Horace. But I was going to say to you was, goodbye.
What?
Goodbye.
Hold on.
No, Horace, I failed, and when a woman fails, there's nothing else she can say. But, goodbye. Goodbye.
$1.35, you see, I'm going into my own business, and since the only thing I know is hand me, I'm opening my own store.
And Cornelius has found the perfect location, right across the street from you.
So you think you can compete with Vandergelders, do you? Well, just you try. Aha! Hello, I'm come calling back, eh? What do you want?
Now that's the past 4 months. $6.12.
You can't do this to me. I'll go to the courts. I'll get lawyers! Now! Clap!
urge to wear bow ties and choke.
Dolly.
No, Horace, I know what you're going to say. You're not satisfied with Ernestina. But I found you the perfect girl, the ideal wife. But don't let me interrupt you. You were doing something. What were you doing? Getting Cornelius' money, Dolly. $126.
And 35 cents. Plus my 612 cents.
And the money my mama left me. $52.48.
38 cents! 38 cents! 38 cents! 38 cents! All right. This is the money you want. It's in the safe upstairs.
Wait
in that side room over there.
Money. Mr. Vandergelder's money. It's like the sun we walk under. It can kill or cure. Now, Vandergeld is never tired of saying that most people in the world are fools. And in a way, he's right, isn't he? Himself, Cornelius, myself. Yet we're all fools, and we're all in danger of destroying the world in our folly. But the surest way to keep us out of harm is to give us the 4 or 5 simple human pleasures that are right in the world. And that takes a little money. Now, the difference between a little money and no money at all is enormous. And that can change the world. And the difference between an enormous amount of money and no money at all is very slight. And that can change the world, too. You see, my husband, Evan Levi, always used to say that money, pardon the expression, is like manure. It's not worth a thing unless it's spread around encouraging young things to grow. Anyhow, that's the opinion of the second Mrs. Vandergelder, which reminds me, Ephraim, I'm ready for that sign.
Don't just stand there, you. That goes upstairs.
Oh, of course, as I was saying before, I found you the ideal wife.
Dolly Gallagher! I don't want you to find me no more ideal wives. If I want an ideal wife, I'll find one of my own. And I found her! It's you, damn it!
My horse.
I know I've been an idiot about Mrs. Malloy and that other woman, but Dolly, forgive me and marry me.
You know as well as I do that you're the first citizen of Yonkers, and as your wife, I would have to be a somebody. Answer me, Horace. Am I a somebody?
You are. Wonderful woman.
No, Horace, it's not enough. It's not enough to load your wife with money and jewels and insist she be a benefactress to half the town. Which, by the way, that reminds me. It's bad business letting Cornelius open up a shop right across the street from you. Better take him back and let him be your partner.
Partner?
And Barnaby can have Cornelius' old job.
Hold on,
now. That way we can all dance together at Ernie Mark's wedding.
Oh, that does it? I'll dance in no ways. Besides, I don't know how. It would take me weeks, months, years, but what? All right, we'll dance.
Horace, I never thought I'd hear you say a thing like that.
Hey! No.
Front room, idiot. Poor Vandergelder, what's going on up there?
Oh, nothing. I just thought I'd have this front room done over in blue wallpaper.
Horace?
I know the old paper ain't worn out yet, but that fellow's just set up shop. Means a good start. You see, Dolly, the way I see it, money, pardon the expression, is like manure. It's not worth a thing unless it's...
Thank you, Ephraim.
Hello, Dolly. Hello, Dolly. It's so nice to have you here where you belong. I never knew Dolly without you, Dolly.
now that